can Facebook do to get its reputation back? And yes, its stock will be higher again. One thing's certain, what they're doing now is not working. Yesterday, Facebook's VP of marketing, Carolyn Everson, told an audience that the company is, and I quote, beyond disturbed by the data scandal. And, quote, it's an incredible violation of everything we stand for. Okay, that's terrific. Except who the heck is Carolyn Everson? And what's she doing making these comments at some Shop Talk retail conference? Bushlit. Facebook's a huge $488 billion company with not one but two household name executives, Mark Zuckerberg, and he's the founder and CEO, Sheryl Sandberg, chief operating officer. Zuck and Sheryl, they both have to come out and face the music, even if it's a funeral dirge. So here's what they should do. First, Zuck needs to come out of hiding and say, we screwed up, we apologize, it will never happen again. Sounds straightforward, but anyone who's seen the social network knows that Zuckerberg wasn't exactly Mr. Humility even before he founded Facebook. Here's the thing. They both need to take full responsibility for whatever Cambridge Analytica did, regardless of whether or not they think they deserve to. They can't keep saying that it wasn't a data breach or it wasn't their data breach. That may even be true. Who cares? This is the court of public opinion, people, where you're guilty until proven innocent. And if they're not careful, it will end up being the court of law, because the Senate, the House, and the FTC are all going to suggest that Facebook has too much market power. There are two ways to approach this issue. There's the Steve Ballmer route, when Microsoft was being investigated for having too much power back in the day. CEO Ballmer famously said, we don't care what Janet Reno thinks. There were some meaner things associated, too. Well, Janet Reno happened to be the Attorney General of the United States. With that attitude, Microsoft found it, whoa, boy, found itself on the wrong side of a monopoly power lawsuit, and stock fell 15 points, 105 to 90, when the verdict was announced. Then there's the Jamie Dimon approach. When lawmakers were investigating J.P. Morgan's London Wales scandal, basically a gigantic trading loss that never should have happened, CEO Dimon threw himself on their mercy. He said, we were not only dumb, we were stupid. That admission was brilliant. Be like Dimon, not Bomber. On top of that, Zuck and Sheryl should forego any salary or stock options until this mess is cleared up. Facebook should take every opportunity to explicitly state that you may want to opt out of any survey, because they can only do so much to police how your data gets used. It should be at the top, like a cigarette warning. Most of all, though, they need to recognize the truth is a total distraction and abstraction in these situations. I recommend, and this is really important, guys, do this. Appointing the equivalent of a special prosecutor who's above reproach to investigate. I suggest Kenneth Feinberg, the man who investigated claims for the GM ignition switch defect. He handled the payouts from the 9/11 and from the Deepwater Horizon problems. And once he's hired, Facebook should do everything he says, even if offering recompense if it would help. Oh, and Memo to Mark Zuckerberg, when you go before the Senate, you need to say just one thing. We made a mistake, and we're sorry. If you don't know how to feign remorse, go look at the testimony of the bank CEOs in front of Congress. They apologized repeatedly and went away. Finally, go make some friends, please. Isn't that what Facebook's like? Isn't that why it was invented in the first place? Zuckerberg needs to spend some time in Washington, schmooze with some good lawyer, go on Jimmy Fallon, go on Stephen Colbert, and go on Jimmy Kimmel, and be human. Yep, the future of Facebook stock depends on Mark Zuckerberg's ability to show some humility, and for Sheryl Sandberg to be the Sheryl we thought we knew. Stick with Quick. As an